Hey guys, what's happening? My name's Cal, and in today's video, I'm going to be sharing with you 10 of my favorite Android Studio shortcuts. These are shortcuts that I personally use, and they've sort of slowly been integrated into my workflow over the last few years, and they're pretty much shortcuts I couldn't live without now. And hopefully, there's some shortcuts in here that you're not using that you could maybe, after watching this video, start using to make your workflow a bit faster and a bit more efficient, and just overall make you a better Android Studio developer. Cool, so the first Android Studio shortcut I want to share with you guys is duplicate current line. Command D on a Mac or Control D on Windows. So say you're creating a simple class in Java, so you've got an ID, name, and created. And then you want to have a few more date fields. Well, you could just hit Command D or Control D and duplicate that current line a few more times and change the text to whatever you like. The second Android Studio shortcut is basically the opposite. It's delete whatever current line you're on. Command Delete if you're on a Mac and Control Y if you're on Windows. All it does is removes the current line. Rather than having to hit backspace a bunch of times, you're just going to remove the complete current line. And next up we have generate code or generate constructors and getters and setters. So it's Command N on a Mac or Alt Insert if you're on Windows. And if you've followed along with any of my previous Android Studio tutorials, you'll have most likely seen me generate some code of some description. So here I'm just generating a constructor. So Command N or Alt Insert, and I'm going to generate some getters and setters. I believe if you have a good understanding of the code you're generating, there's absolutely no harm in generating your code. In fact, I think it will save you a lot of time. Next up, we have neatly format code or reformat code. And on a Mac, it's Command Option L. And on Windows, it's Control Alt L. Sometimes when you know you copy and paste from somewhere else, it just doesn't all quite line up correctly. Well, if you hit Command Option L or Control Alt L, it's just going to reformat everything back to what you've defined in your preferences. And if like me, you like to have your curly brackets on the next line, if you head into Preferences, Editor, Code Style, Java, Wrapping and braces placement, next line for each one of those. And if we reformat our code once again, now that we've made those changes in the preferences, you can see that it's put each curly bracket on a new line, which has made my little OCD brain quite happy and content. The next Android Studio shortcut is also a bit of a neatening one. It's optimize imports, Control Option O on a Mac, and Control Alt O on Windows. Basically, all this does is if you add in a few extra import statements and then you remove the things that use those imports, we organize our imports and it removes all of the import statements so that the only ones that are left in the file are the ones that are used. Moving on, our next shortcut is find class or open class, and it's Command O on a Mac or Control N on Windows. Say you want to move to a different class, you can just search for it and then open it up. So in this example, I've just searched for my main activity and I've opened it up. This is a really useful shortcut if you're working on a bigger project and all your different files are nested in a bunch of different folders and you know that that class exists. So rather than searching for it the old fashioned way, looking through the files, you're just going to search for it via the text. Next up, we have go to declaration. And I don't know, this is a bit of a stretch to whether this is even a shortcut, but it's a huge time saver and one of my favorite ones. So it's just command click or control click. Basically, say you've declared a object and we're going to declare our Android shortcuts object and just giving it some dummy data because it doesn't really matter. And then if you hold down command or control and hover over the method, you can actually see the little mouse is changed to pointer finger. And then if you click on it, you go to the declaration of the method. And you can, so say if it's a really basic method and you just want to see what it does, you can quickly pop in, have a look at what the method does, and then head back to where you were. Next up, we have go to line. And on a Mac, it's command L, and Windows, it's control G. Not a super useful shortcut if you're working on a lot of solo projects, but if you're working together as part of a team, it's a really great one. You can just tell your mate, hey, have a look at this file, line 51, and you can just quickly pop there and have a look. Next up, we have find in file, and I'd be surprised if anyone's watching this and they don't already know this shortcut, but I figure it's worth mentioning just in case someone doesn't use Command F. It's one of the most useful shortcuts, well, in anything you do on a computer, really. Just hit Command F or Control F and search for anything in the file. It's really useful. I mean, use it on your web browser, use it in Android Studio, use it in everything. And finally, following up from that, we have Command Shift F or Control Shift F, which is find in project. It does exactly the same thing as Command F or Control F, except instead of just looking in the file that you're currently in, it's looking throughout your entire Android Studio project. This is a particularly useful shortcut I find when you're refactoring your codes.
So there you have it, 10 pretty useful shortcuts in Android Studio. If there's any that I missed or you thought, you know, that one wasn't a very good shortcut, or you know, I missed any important ones, do leave a comment below and I'll be sure to check it out. That was it. If you like this different sort of style of video, consider giving it a like. But yeah, I'll catch you guys in the next video or tutorial.